1996 saw the 50th anniversary of the death of Percy Whitlock, probably not a familiar name unless you're a habitual goer to organ recitals. Whitlock was one of a generation of organists who found no difficulty in straddling the church organ loft and the concert hall. In fact, during the 1930s, he was both organist at St Stephen's Parish Church and the Pavilion in Bournemouth, and his own compositions can also be equally well suited to either situation. Robert Gower is president of the Percy Whitlock Trust, and he'll be playing Whitlock's Plymouth Suite and the air transcribed from the Prelude, Air and Fugue. But he begins with two movements from Whitlock's set of five short pieces. Robert Gower has chosen the first and last, Allegretto and Paean, and they're both good examples of the effortlessness and tunefulness that flow in Whitlock's music.
Thank you.
Paean, and before that, the Allegretto from Five Short Pieces by Percy Whitlock, played by Robert Gower. He recorded this programme at Rochester Cathedral in Kent, and like most cathedral organs, it's been rebuilt and enlarged many times over the last 200 years, perhaps most significantly in 1905 by Walker and Sons. Now it boasts four manuals and pedals and 64 stops. It's a particularly good choice for Whitlock's music, as Robert Gower explains.
It's a wonderful instrument, recently restored and enlarged in 1989 by Manda, and a good acoustic, but above that, really, it's got intimate links with Whitlock, who was a chorister here. And we're told that in his early days, in the age of 9 and 10, he used to stand in the choir stalls down there, and perhaps when he should have been singing his heart out, he was actually sliding the hymn books on the stalls around, trying to imitate the stops on the organ. So he had that real itch to get onto the organ, which he did at a very early age. And he was assistant organist here, in fact, for 8 years or so in the 1920s. But the wonderful thing is, when you come here and you're registering the music, you're practicing away, actually, basically what you do is what he wrote at the top of the page. And that's another attraction for the organist. You really do use the sounds of the instrument.
Robert Gower. Next, he plays a piece which Whitlock could never have performed himself at Rochester because it's only recently been transcribed for organ. As well as music for his own instrument, Whitlock also wrote a good deal of orchestral music. The Prelude, Air and Fugue was first performed in 1939 in the Bournemouth Easter Music Festival by the resort's municipal orchestra. But just a few years ago, the secretary of the Whitlock Trust, Malcolm Riley, made a transcription for organ of the Central Movement. And as Whitlock must have played many transcriptions himself in his Sunday afternoon recitals at the Bournemouth Pavilion between the wars, I can't help feeling that he would have approved. The Air from the Prelude, Air and Fugue, played by Robert Gower on the organ in Rochester Cathedral. In some ways, it seems strange that as a performer, Whitlock could move so readily between the concert platform and the church, and his music too has a degree of ambiguity about it.
Whitlock himself was this mixture of the sacred and the secular. I think, actually, he represents the English recitalist of the period. And even in the miniatures, you can use the miniatures, obviously, as voluntaries. But it's wonderful music. It's real heart on the sleeve. It's emotion-packed. There's a real intensity that drives it along. He used to boogie away on the organ. He wouldn't come up, you know, from the ground with the lights flashing all around him. That was a bit too much. But he certainly used to extemporise on the popular tunes of the time.
Robert Gower, and there's certainly no shortage of tunes in the last work he's going to play, The Plymouth Suite. Whitlock wrote this collection in 1937, a year in which the Congress of the Incorporated Association of Organists met in Plymouth, hence the title. There are five short movements: Allegro Resoluto, Lantana, Shanti, Salix, and Toccata.
It's a sort of an organist enigma variations because it seems to portray very much the characters of the people involved. The fourth movement is dedicated to Austin Dewdney, music critic in Bournemouth, and the title Salix means a weeping willow, and he was somebody really who never had any good perhaps to say about people, was always looking on the gloomier side of life, and so there's a bit of Whitlock's impish sense of humour that comes through there.
Thank you. Percy Whitlock's Plymouth Suite, played by Robert Gower on the organ in Rochester Cathedral.